The Philippines again lands at the bottom of Bloomberg's COVID Resilience Index for January 2022. After rising to the 50th spot in December, the country again found itself dead last in a list of 53 nations ranked according to how effectively they are handling the virus. Bloomberg notes vaccine coverages played a factor in the latest index, as previous supply issues for developing countries have evolved into a logistical challenge of reaching people in rural areas with little to no health infrastructure. Officials leading the Philippines' pandemic response have yet to make a statement on this, but they have previously blamed Bloomberg's emphasis on reopening progress for the country's ranking.
More areas in the Philippines are placed under the country's third highest COVID alert level. These are the provinces of Palawan, Camiguin, Davao Occidental, Dinagat Islands, Tawi-Tawi, and Sulu. The new alert level will be in effect from Friday until February 15.
The Philippines logged more than 18,000 new COVID cases Thursday, bringing the total to nearly 3.5 million. Active cases stand at 226,000. The health department also recorded 74 additional deaths, as well as 22,000 recoveries. The Octa Research Group points out five cities in the National Capital Region have now become moderate risk for COVID-19 transmission. These are Caloocan, Navotas, Malabon, Valenzuela, and Manila. For the UP Pandemic Response Team, the improvising numbers in NCR means the government can now shift its focus and resources to the provinces.
Kasi marami sa mga provinces less yung mga less vaccination coverage at less ang healthcare capacity. For the Cordillera itself sa region, medyo tumaas yung ating ICU occupancy. Kailangan itong tutukan din yung Region 5. Talagang nag-increase po ang ICU occupancy sa Region 5. At isa sa mga kailangan tingnan din natin yung sa Mindanao.
Meanwhile, the Philippines also detected 618 additional cases of the Omicron variant. This brings the total number of confirmed Omicron infections in the country to 1,153. Out of 618, 497 were local cases, while 121 were returning overseas Filipinos. Of the local cases, nearly half were from Metro Manila. The health department says 13 of the additional Omicron cases are still active, while 560 were tagged as recovered. The status of 43 patients is still being verified. Five Omicron deaths have been reported so far.
The Philippine government urged to come up with a pandemic exit strategy for relaxing restrictions. Presidential Advisor for Entrepreneurship Joey Concepcion and Octa Research Fellow Father Nicanor Ostriaco are calling on the pandemic task force to start the country's transition from a pandemic mindset to a endemic mindset. They point out the Omicron surge has already peaked in Metro Manila and is expected to peak in other regions in the next 2 weeks. The two also say a significant number of Filipinos have already acquired immunity from COVID-19, either through infection or vaccination. They believe it's time to reinstate past international travel protocols, noting that opening up the country to the world will have many downstream benefits to the economy. They also urge government to set an example and encourage more Filipinos to get vaccinated.
A majority of Filipinos are willing to get a COVID-19 booster shot. That's according to the latest SWS survey, which shows 4 out of 5 of 80% of adult Filipinos are okay with getting an additional dose of the vaccine. 7% are unwilling, while 13% are unsure. The study was conducted from December 12 to 16, 2021, with over 1,400 respondents. The same survey showed only 8% of adult Filipinos are unwilling to get vaccinated against the coronavirus, 10 percentage points lower than September's 18%.
The Philippine government plans to hold dedicated vaccination days for children aged 5 to 11. Vaccine Chief Carlito Galvez Jr. says the planned immunization drive may be held on February 4 to 5, with 24 hospital and non-hospital settings in Metro Manila serving as the designated inoculation sites. He adds guidelines for this will also be released next week.
Gusto po natin talaga magkaroon to ng tinatawag na phasing at saka sequence. Alam po naman natin na itong sektor na to napaka-importante at saka very sensitive po talaga. At considering na first time natin na makatanggap ng children formulation, ay talagang titingnan po natin talaga na safe at saka effective po yung ating gagawin na pagbabakuna. So ang gagawin po natin, magde-designate po tayo ng dalawang hospital and non-hospital based each city po dito sa Metro Manila. So 7 cities and municipality. Yung ibang region nga po maapila, yung region 3 and 4 na gusto lang sumabay.
Overseas, Sweden decides against recommending COVID vaccines for kids aged 5 to 11. The country's health agency believes the benefits of vaccination do not outweigh the risks, since current data show low risk for serious disease among young children. But it adds the decision could be revisited if the research changes or if a new variant changes in the pandemic situation. Meanwhile, children in high-risk groups can already get the vaccine. Sweden registered more than 40,000 new cases on Wednesday, one of the highest daily tallies during the pandemic. But even with a fourth wave, Sweden's healthcare system is not under the same strain as during previous surges.
The European Union's drug regulator greenlights Pfizer's antiviral COVID-19 pill for high-risk patients. This comes as the region scrambles to boost its arsenal to fight the Omicron variant. The European Medicines Agency's conditional approval of Paxlovid paves the way for EU member states to deploy the drug after the regulator gave guidance for its emergency use late last year. Italy, Germany, and Belgium are among the handful of European countries that have bought the drug. The United States in December also authorized Paxlovid and Merck's similar drug, Molnupiravir. These oral drugs are seen as promising new treatment options that can be taken at home at the onset of COVID-19 symptoms to help prevent hospitalizations and deaths.